Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Naveen and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this episode, we are going to learn how to develop an app using AWS Honeycode. In one of our previous Learn Technology in 5 Minute videos, we have introduced you to the Amazon Honeycode. Now let us learn how to build a simple app for assigning tasks to your team members using the Honeycode. After logging into the Honeycode account, click on this Create Workbook and select the Start from Scratch option. Now we will be redirected to the Tabular Columns section. We can store the backend data required to build the app here. Now let us rename these columns so that we can access the app data more easily. It is tiresome to manually enter all these data, so why don't we put a pick list for some of these columns? Click on this Tables icon here and then click on the plus symbol to create a new table. Right click on this new table and rename it as Editors. Inside this table, we will add the names of all the editors. Now let us do the same and create a new table that will have all the instructors' name and then finally another table that contains the timeline status as you see here. Now go to the first table. We will rename it as Tasks. Now let us learn how to link these tables and then create a pick list. Select the Wizards option. Now select Create Pick List from here. Now there will be two columns with drop-down menu options for you. From the first one, select Tasks and then from the second one, select the Editor option. Click on the Existing Table option and now select Editors. Once that is done, click on Apply and you will find a pick list option on the Editor column. Click here and you can see that the editor's names have appeared and you can select whom you want. Do the same for the instructor column and the timeline column. Now let us build the app. Select the builder option and you will be redirected to a new screen. Click on this icon if you want to link or unlink your mobile and web app versions. Before starting, let us rename the screen and use the same as our screen name here. Now select this space here and click on Add Objects. Since this is our home screen, let us put the name of all the employees here. Use the stack list option for that and select the editor table. Make sure you select this add a detailed screen option and then click on create. Now you can see a box with the heading and the name. Use the stack list again for showing the name of all the instructors. Click on this view app option to see how the home screen of your app looks now. Now let us create the task assigning screen. Let us use the Add Objects option again to add a button here, which will guide us to another screen where we can assign the tasks. So select a button from the Add Object option. Right click on the button and rename it. Now click on this button and you will see some options on the right side of the screen. Click on the Actions and select Navigate to New Screen option under Quick Actions. Select the option to create a new screen from this drop-down menu and the automation of the button is done. We will find the new screen here on the left side. Rename the screen and select the workspace and select Form from Add Objects. Since we have already created a button to navigate us to a new screen, let us click on this second option. Select Tasks from this drop-down menu and the options that you want the team to fill and click on Create. This is where we will enter our data. Select the Done button and go to Actions. Click on Edit Automation. The automation for the screen is automatically done here. We can add new automation if we want. Now click on this Navigate option here and make sure you have selected the home screen as we want to return to the home screen once the task is assigned. Now let us check the working of our app by clicking on the View App option. Click on the button. Great, it is working. Now let us enter some data here and see if the data entered here is being saved in our tabular column. Great, the data is saved in the tabular column. Now let us go to automation and add automation to receive a notification when new data is entered. Select the row added or deleted option and select the tasks table as we are currently only adding data to the tasks table. Click on this add actions if you want to add more automation. Now that everything is done, click on publish to publish your automation. If you wish to share the workbook with your team members, then click on the share workbook option. You may load it in an Android or iPhone by downloading the AWS Honeycode app and signing into your Honeycode account. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.